Hey guys, Jeremy here, and today we're talking turkey, beer brined spatchcock turkey. So one of the most important parts of a successful cook is preparation, making sure you have everything ready to go, everything done before the day of the cook. So today is Friday, and we're gonna be cooking this turkey on Sunday. So what I've already done is the last couple days, on Wednesday, I made up a butter, a compound butter that you'll be seeing later on, and we'll put links down to the recipes at the bottom. And last night I mixed up a brine that this bird is gonna be taking a bath in over the next 48 hours. Today we're gonna be doing a process called spatchcocking. And spatchcocking is an easy process that is gonna be removing the backbone, which is gonna help the bird lay flatter, cook faster, and more even. All right, so this is the top part of the turkey where the breast is. We want to flip this over, and this is the part we want, this going right through all of those bones that are in there. There it is, the backbone. Our shears, and we're going to start cutting right along one side up, getting in there good. This is where the right tool, some good sharp scissors come in. There you go. Now, as you can see, it's already opened up, but we want to go ahead and repeat the same process on the other side. It's completely removed, and as you can see, it took some squeezing there to get through a couple of those bones, so having the right tools to cut that through would be the great thing to have. And this can be thrown out. You can keep a hold of it. It can be left over and put in a pot for some stock. Today, I'm just gonna be tossing it. We don't need it anymore for the rest of this cook. As you can see, it's cut open. It's pretty wide open here, but we want it to be laid out even more. So we're gonna flip this over, put it back on its back, and bring this breast up. Now, we're gonna focus on getting this thing to lay a lot flatter. So what we want to do is we want to get right in here through this breastbone, and we want to give it a good crack to flatten it out. So with your hands, you can just pressure in here, and get in there and give it a, oh, there you go. Crackety backety, there it is. So that bird's laying nice and flat now. So now that we've got this turkey good and flattened out and completed the process of spatchcocking, we're going to talk about brining. We're going to put this in a brine for the next 2 days and let it absorb some of that moisture, because we know as we cook turkey and poultry, things like this, it tends to dry out a little bit, and sometimes it affects the skin. So we're gonna try to put moisture into that and flavor into this bad boy. So what I did last night is I mixed up a wonderful looking brine here, involving some water, some lemons, some oranges, peppercorns, basil, thyme, garlic. So we'll have this recipe listed down below later on. But we're gonna put this bird into a container that's gonna be big enough for it to be submerged and covered in all this wonderful goodness. So when it comes to brining, you can use any kind of a container that'll cover and hold the bird. I just like using a basic bucket from a hardware store. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take this wonderful brine that we've mixed up, and we're just gonna pour it in that container. Yeah. Get all the goodness in there. Then we're gonna take the bird, place it in there. But first, we said this was a beer brined spatchcock turkey. We are gonna be putting in a Kansas City style golden lager, 2 bottles of this. Beer for the bird, beer for the cook. Put one in there. Now we're gonna add in that bird. Next, we're gonna top it off with a little bit of water till it's completely covered. Slap on the lid, put this baby in the fridge. All right, guys, today's the day. It's Sunday. We're ready to get this bird on the grill and get it prepared for our family for dinner tonight. What's been going on is this guy's been soaking for the last 2 days, since Friday. And earlier today, about 2 hours ago, I took this thing out, dried it off, put it on a pan, let it sit in the fridge to chill out, which is gonna help the skin be a little bit more bite through and tasty. All right guys, the next step to seasoning this bird and getting it ready for the grill is gonna be using this compound butter. I mixed this up the other night. It has a little bit of thyme, parsley, rosemary, garlic, and of course, that SDQ sweet garlic rub. Sounds fantastic.
What's up, dude?
Hey, speaking of sweet, sweet SDQ garlic rub, what's up, man?
What's up, everybody?
Hey, nice to join us. So, Josh joined us over here for the cook today.
Yeah, man.
What you been doing?
Just hanging out, dude. Got a turkey going, huh?
That's right, brother. That's right. We're gonna get this going.
So we got a full Thanksgiving Day meal, huh?
Yep. All right. First thing we're gonna do here. You ready? Ready for operation?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go.
Let's get it going.
So, what first thing we want to do when it comes down to getting this butter in here is we are going to start separating the skin from the bird. So if you see right up underneath here, gently bring your fingers in, and we're just gonna nicely tear a little bit of that area out and remove it from each other.
Why is that so important, Jeremy?
Well, I'm gonna disconnect this from the skin, and you can see that area there. If I tried shoving butter up in there right now, it wouldn't be onto the breast. The purpose of this here is we're gonna try to season plus add moisture to this bird. The white meat, the breast meat, it always dries out a little bit faster. We wanna keep that nice and tender and moist, so.
When you're actually cooking this, and we get this back here on one of the two beauties that we got rolling today, what are your end times gonna be, and are you taking it just to the breast meat when you're cooking it?
Our time's gonna be different. Of course, the breast meat is gonna be done a little bit faster, the white meat, but we're gonna be doing internal temperatures on the breast meat, but our white meat and our thighs are gonna be a little bit different. But first, okay. Hey man, let's get
yeah,
some of this
no,
awesome
for sure,
butter
for sure.
Up underneath here.
This so. Butter's gonna be fantastic, man.
Now that we've removed the skin and got an open area for it, now let's apply that butter to it. We're gonna focus on the breast here, and then getting into a little bit of the top of the legs. That's all we're focused on right now. Getting it up underneath there.
You're really getting it down in all the parts of it.
Oh yeah.
That's awesome. All right, so now that you got this butter in there, you ready to season this thing or what?
Yeah, what do you think we need to do?
I don't know, what rub are you putting on there?
Thinking about this, about the kitchen sink, a great product from Smokin' Brothers. It's gonna be sweet, mild, it's gonna be a great color.
Yeah, no, I think it's gonna be great.
Let's kill it, let's roll. Go. Put a good little coating on this all over, babe. Cover it up, make it look pretty.
Pretty bird.
Wanna be generous with this.
Yeah, no, you should. So we got a Premier 30 plus going, and we got a Premier going. What vessel are we putting this thing in today?
Well, I was thinking we just put it on that Premier 30.
Cool.
Get it going on there.
What temperature are we gonna cook this thing on?
Got it set at 250 right now. Gotta load it up with a 50-50 blend of cherry and hickory.
Oh, that'd be nice.
That'd be good?
Yeah, that'd be really good. Okay, so what are we thinking time-wise?
That should be about 2.5-3 hours.
I mean, the end of the day, it's always about internal temperature.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's never actually about time, but if we're gonna try to estimate it, that's why I was asking.
Yeah, so I think we're gonna be shooting for like 158, 160.
Right.
Get that internal temperature. We're gonna be focused on the internal temperature of that breast, as you were talking about earlier.
Right.
In the breast side versus the thigh. And then we'll pull that off, and as it sets there for a little bit, it'll continue to rise up to that 165 or so.
Sure.
Should be nice and juicy and bite through.
In the dark meat, it's okay for it to go longer.
Oh, yeah.
Just because it's dark meat, it's a little fattier for what it is. So no worries there for what it is. Now, obviously, we're gonna flip this thing over, and we're gonna hit the backside of this too with rub as well.
A little bit,
correct?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. A little bit, we're focusing on that. So we've already been able to put all that flavor into it with this brine.
Mm-hmm.
Put that flavor in underneath
mm-hmm.
that skin. And that's what we talked about, protecting that breast, because that breast is gonna dry out a little bit faster. And then now we're just topping it off with this lovely rub. You'll let it sit here and sweat for a little bit. And then we're gonna finally give it that last flavor of those pellets going on.
Yeah.
We will hit it with a little bit of butter throughout the cook a couple times.
Just by basting it?
Just basting it with some high quality butter, some Irish butter, and call it good. So this thing's been sitting here sweating for about 20 minutes, letting that letting that awesome rub absorb into the skin.
Color's great. Looks really good. I think we're ready to roll, dude.
Let's get it on.
Yeah, man. Let's get this thing on.
I gotcha. All right, we're gonna let this thing cruise for about an hour, hour and 15 minutes.
Turkey's on. Now we get to the fun part, the sides of Thanksgiving. I'm gonna make with you one of my favorite things, broccoli cheese casserole. Super simple side dish, guys. I'm really gonna take 1 cup of pre-cooked rice that I did earlier. I'm gonna mix it in a bowl. And really, I'm just gonna add all of these ingredients together, guys. Got this. Did some actual broccoli that steamed up earlier. Take my milk. This is the cheese that's going in here. Velveeta. It's a 1 pound block. Just pulled this off the smoker from being melted a little bit. Getting ready to mix this in here with the other ingredients. I'm gonna add all the rest of the stuff that's here, some mushrooms, some butter, onion. So got the rice, got the broccoli, adding the butter. The milk's in here already as well. Some mushrooms. One small onion diced. Can of cream of mushroom soup. Make sure we get all this. This important stuff here. So now I'm gonna add the start of the dish. I'm gonna get the cheese off the smoker. You're gonna follow me in here. This is the Velveeta cheese that we've been melting on the smoker. Now that this is in here, I'm gonna come back over. I'm gonna add some of my SDQ Classic. About a quarter cup. You can really use your favorite barbecue rub. This is a sweet rub, a little bit of smokiness to it. Really, it's just fantastic. It's gonna add just a little bit of sweetness to it. End of the day, this is just an awesome casserole. Now that I got everything mixed up here, I'm gonna move over to a casserole dish. Gonna pre-grease this. And then it's just a matter of putting everything inside here. Make sure you get everything here. You don't want to leave anything behind. You just worked hard at making all this. All right, now we got everything in the dish. I'm gonna top it off with some more SDQ. Now we're gonna move this thing over to the Smoker Brothers Premier 30. It's gonna go in there for at 350 for about 20 minutes, and then we'll be good to go.
Staying on the topic of sides, here's a fantastic side that we enjoy having in our family. Actually, my sister-in-law, Sarah, she introduced this to us. It's a warm Tex-Mex sweet potato salad. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna chop up a pound of red potatoes and a pound of sweet potatoes. Just gonna cube these up into decent sizes. Don't want them too big, don't want them too small. We want these things to be able to cook up evenly. Next, we're gonna do the same with the sweet potato. Now that we got those all together, we're gonna mix them up a little bit. We're gonna toss them on a pre-greased cookie sheet. Spread them out evenly. Then we're gonna throw these bad boys on the grill at 375 for about 35 40 minutes. All right, so the potato's been on for about 35, 40 minutes. Time to check on these guys. Oh yeah, they're looking great. Let's pull these bad boys off. Next step is we're gonna take these potatoes and we're gonna add them to a bowl. Yeah. Next, we're gonna add in some onions that we cooked off in a skillet earlier. Gonna give that a little blend here. Lastly, we're gonna add in this awesome sauce. It is a combination of mayo, cilantro, salt, cumin, some lemon zest, and this is gonna bring it to the next level here. Get this all tossed up and it'll be ready to serve. Oh man, so good. It's got the sweetness, got the zestiness, got a little kick from the spices, got a little cayenne in there, got a little onion in there, got that cilantro. Beautiful looking salad, a different use of a sweet potato. Nice warm potato salad here for you. Yeah, baby.
You can't have Thanksgiving turkey without stuffing. We are going to show you how to make the best stuffing on the smoker in a cast iron skillet. You ready for this? Now the butter's melted, I'm going to go ahead and add the onions. And the celery. I'm gonna go ahead and let these sweat down until they're soft. So right after the onions, we added some celery. Like again, just sweating these things down. Let them get soft, translucent. We're gonna add the garlic into it. We'll let this go for about a minute. All right guys, so now I'm adding 3 cups of chicken broth to this. I'm gonna get this all mixed in here. All right, this is where the magic happens. Two of your favorite boxed stuffing mixes. Doesn't matter what they are, but this is what it's all about right here, guys. We're gonna let this bake now for about 25 to 30 minutes.
All right, the sides are done, and the most important thing, the bird is done. It's temped out at around, what did we say it was?
156, 158.
Yeah, so we're gonna take that off right now, get on a platter, take it inside and let it chill for about 10 minutes. We're gonna put it in a little bit of a foil tent to keep it kind of warm, but still let those juices absorb back into it.
We'll continue cooking as well.
Yeah. Get ready to eat?
Yeah, dude, I'm ready. It's been a fun day.
Oh, man. Shining. Looking good. Smells good. I'm excited. Here we go. Ooh, mama. Look at that.